Good evening, good afternoon, whatever time you are watching it, a very good morning, very good things for you people. Now thing is here when we are actually going to start, we are going to end the national income series, and this is going to be the problems in estimation of national income. Now when we are actually speaking about the problems of estimating national incomes, what are the problems? So before we actually discuss that, let's actually go for the thought of the day, right? So thing is here, obviously we have a problem in going for the next slide, right? Yeah, hopefully we will actually go to the next slide. Now, here the thing is problems hey, problem hey. That is the thought for the day actually. See, obviously in everyone's life there will be one problem or the other problem. So how to deal with the problems that we have in our life? See, a great man once actually told, like his name was Aristotle. Aristotle actually tells, right, like it tells, there are two kinds of problem in the world. For the problems, there are one type of problems which have solution, and there are other types of problems which do not have solution. So for the problems which have solution, you don't need to worry because the problems have solution. And for the other problems which don't have solution, again, you don't have to worry because there are no solutions for the problem. All right. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮ್ಮ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ತರ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಗಳಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನೋ ಸಮಾಧಾನ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸಮಾಧಾನ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ನು ಕೆಲವು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಸಮಾಧಾನನೇ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ಸಮಾಧಾನನೇ ಇಲ್ದೇ ಇರೋ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಯಾಕೆ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಟೈಮ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಐಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಐಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ is ain't what it ain't. It's not the end of the world, you see. You just have to see what you have, see what you don't have, see what you can do, see what can't do. What you can't do, you don't worry about what you can't do, and do what you should do so that the problem at hand is actually solved. All right. Okay, now again we will see other problems which we are going to deal with today. Problems in calculating national income. Obviously, for calculating national income there are many problems. National income, it's not easy calculating national income. For obviously, if you have to calculate national income, there are many problems. The first problem is transfer payments. So here, when we are actually speaking about the transfer payments, so what are these transfer payments, right? So transfer payments, when you are actually speaking about transfer payments, so what are transfer payments? See here, transfer payments means government will give you many subsidies, right? Government will obviously give you many subsidies. The subsidies the government actually can give you will be in the form of scholarship, or it can be in the this even the widows will get, and some other things. See, all these money which the government gives for the welfare of the people, even it may be universal basic income, like Rahul Gandhi actually wanted to give some 72,000 rupees per year or something. So obviously that is all this transfer payments, and the transfer payments is, see, the scholarships or universal basic income or subsidies, whatever these things which the government give. Now the question is, should it be included in national income or it should not be included in national income? See, what is national income? National income is the final value of all goods and services produced in the domestic territory of the country. When government is giving you scholarship, it is not that you are producing any good or service. See, obviously you may be getting educated, but for you to get educated, your teacher is teaching you. So that service is provided by your teacher, not you. And you are just consuming the service. So when the government is actually giving you scholarship, when the government is actually giving you scholarship, you are getting money and you are not providing any service for anyone. So now this scholarship should be included in national income or it should not be included in national income. The subsidy, the universal basic income, it should be included or it should not be included. Unemployment allowance, it should be included or it should not be included. Now this actually becomes a problem. Now the next thing is income of foreign firms. Obviously there are big firms, right? There is Tata, there is Mittal, there is, you know, Yahoo, Google, Infosys. There are many multinational companies, Boeing or whatever. So these multinational companies, their income must be included in the country in which it is operating, or it should be included in the country which it actually belongs to. Such as McDonald's. McDonald's is an American company and McDonald's has a branch in India. McDonald's is obviously earning money in India. When McDonald's is actually earning money in India, should its income be included in Indian national income or its income should be included in American national income. This is actually a problem. Now, what you basically have to understand is, what one basically have to understand is, now when we are actually speaking about the McDonald, what IMF, International Monetary Fund. International Monetary Fund. So obviously you have something called as International Monetary Fund. And what does this International Monetary Fund actually tell? The International Monetary Fund actually tells the income. International Monetary Fund actually tells the income which is actually earned by the MNC, the income which is actually earned by the MNC, that must actually be included in the that must actually be included in the country at in which it is located. That is, if McDonald is in India and if McDonald is earning some income, it should be credited to the national income of India. However, if McDonald is making any profits, that profit must be taken, the profit must be included in the national income of America. Now, obviously, now the question comes, what is income and what is profit? Right. So, what is income and what is profit? A big question is that. Because profit is actually part of income. And if you are including profit for USA and you are including income for India, then what is happening? The profit which is actually included in USA is also counted in India because profit is actually part of income, right? So this is obviously a confusion kind of thing is actually being done here. So there is a problem of how to account the income or the profit of these multinational companies. Now thing is, so here next we'll go for the next slide, right? And when we are actually going for the next slide, treatment of government services. See, obviously the government gives many services for the people. Like it gives vaccination for children, it gives defense services, it gives many other services the government actually gives. Now, what is the price you actually will fix for the vaccination or for the defense or whatever? What is the price you actually fix? Because it is not like polio vaccination is there. If polio vaccination is not put, how much the child will actually suffer in his life long? So obviously the price of the government services were the price, we cannot actually fix the price for the services which the government gives. And so even this services, government services, the national income, calculating the actual price of the government services in national income, it actually becomes quite difficult, right? And apart from that, there are some services which cannot be paid at all. See, obviously your mother, right? So obviously your mother will be there. And when your mother is basically there, what is basically happening? Your mother will take care of you. Your mother will cook you food, take care of you, wash your clothes, do everything. Take care of you for like, for 20, 25 years, and even much more than that. Even much more than that, she will take care of you. So thing is, obviously, how much money will actually you give her? Right. How much money will you give her? What is her income? Right. What is her income? Like she is actually giving you a valuable service, and obviously she is not getting anything for it. And here, obviously, when you are actually speaking about the soldier, there are many faceless soldiers who are guarding this nation day in and day out. Our tandai tayi hentai maklus snehitru yarnor nodai ralla andre in varshake yesala northaram. Right. So the thing is, these people leave their child, leave their parents, leave their wife, and they guard for the safety and security of the nation. Obviously, they are being paid some salary, be it 20,000 or 30,000 or whatever. But thing is, it what they are actually gambling for that 20 or 30,000, they are gambling their life for it. They are actually gambling for their life for it. And if I tell any of you who are actually listening that I will pay you 30,000 or 40,000 and you risk your life for the nation, I don't think many of you will be agreeing for it. So that is something. So this the defense service or the what the sacrifice our soldier is actually doing for our country, again, this actually becomes invaluable. You cannot actually fix the price for it. So how can we calculate these things in national income becomes a problem. Next, there is some income which is also generated from illegal activities, smuggling and all those things. All those things are actually services, kidnapping, smuggling, all these things are actually services. And you have this opium, ganja. Even these drugs are actually produced and these drugs are actually sold. Opium, ganja, heroin, and all those things. Heroin and all those things. So obviously, these drugs and all these things are actually manufactured, they're sold. And these things, the income, the whatever, they will actually not tell. The robbers will not tell, or the drug mafia, drug lords will not tell to the government that this year we made 1 lakh rupees by manufacturing drugs. and 40,000 rupees was our cost of production, 60,000 rupees was our profit. Obviously, no one is going to tell it. If anyone is obviously going to tell it, that person would obviously be put in jail, right? So this is something like which we basically have to understand. And obviously, income is income, money is money is money, as Shakespeare would put it. A rose is a rose is a rose. So obviously, here what we basically have to understand is this. The income which is generated from illegal activities, the income which is generated from illegal activities will not, although it is money, although it is income, although it is a good and service which is produced, it cannot be included in national income, because none of the robbers or none of this drug mafia, these people will definitely not actually declare this is their income or something which. And here the next thing is changing general price level. See, obviously the prices keeps on increasing, but our salary will obviously will not be increasing at the rate at which the prices are increasing. Salary will remain low, the prices will be high, and this is something which we have to like take into consideration. Now here what we basically have to understand is, see here, obviously here in a country if there is a drought or something. Suppose in a country there is a drought, right? Bargala bantu anta ankonde. Suppose if there is drought, then obviously what will happen? The prices of the commodities will definitely increase. The prices of goods will definitely increase. Now when the prices are basically increasing, then what will happen? See, suppose, let's actually take this example. Now actually let's go for screen. In screen, let's go for black. See here what I'm actually saying. There is drought. There is actually drought in the country. And because there is drought in the country, what will happen? Agricultural production. What do you have? Agricultural. You have production. Agricultural production has gone down. And since agricultural production has actually gone down, it will imply that the price of agricultural product actually increases. See, suppose in a normal year, what is happening? The country was growing 10 kg of wheat. Right. Suppose in the normal year, like what is happening? In the normal year, the country was actually growing. In the normal year, what is happening? The country is growing 10 kg of wheat. And for the 10 kg of wheat, in the normal year, it is actually getting 2 rupees. So the national income of the country, assuming that the country is growing only wheat, the national income of the country is 20. Now, the drought has happened. Because of drought, the country is actually growing 5 kg of wheat. The country is growing only 5 kg of wheat, right? Now, since the country is growing 5 kg of wheat, the wheat agricultural production has come down because of the drought. Because of drought, agricultural production has basically come down. And since agricultural production has come down, then what is happening? 5 kg of wheat is actually grown. 5 kg of wheat, the price actually increases to rupees 5. Now the country's national income is 25 rupees. Now the country's national income has increased from 20 rupees to 25 rupees. However, we can actually see that the production has actually fallen down from 10 kg to 5 kg. So although the goods which is actually produced in the country has decreased, the national income has artificially increased. That doesn't mean that the goods which is actually produced in the nation has increased. So when inflation happens, so thing is, when inflation basically happens, then what we actually see is the national income artificially increases. When inflation basically happens, then what we actually see is the national income will artificially increase. So that is a problem in calculating national income. Next, the another problem of calculating national income is the production for self-consumption. See, people may actually have house gardens in which they may be growing tomatoes, in which they may be growing some tomatoes, peas, cabbages, and minchinkayi. So thing is, obviously, that is all these things they will actually chilies. They grow chilies. So these things are actually kept, these goods are manufactured, but the goods are actually kept for self-consumption. Right. Although the goods are manufactured, the goods are actually kept for self-consumption. And this actually creates a problem. Because although goods are manufactured, the country's government does not know that the good is manufactured because these people are actually manufacturing the goods in the house and they are eating it by themselves. Right. So the government will not be knowing what is manufactured, what is not manufactured. So although the goods are produced in the country, it is not accounted for in national income. And because of this, whatever the real value of national income, it is undermined. Suppose the goods kept for self-consumption is 20 rupees. National income is 100 rupees. But you had to actually calculate the goods which is actually kept for consumption. So 100 plus 20 rupees, 120 rupees. So 100 plus 20 rupees, 120 rupees was your national income. But that 20 rupees you are not counting. That 20 rupees you are not counting because you don't know that this much amount of goods was actually produced in the houses of the people. So what will happen? The national income is 100 rupees only. So what will happen? The national income becomes only 100 rupees only. So 20 rupees is not counted. So 20 rupees is not counted, and that is actually like undermining of national income. So this is also what we'll have. This is also a problem which we actually see in estimating national income. Another problem of estimating national income is problem of double counting. See, double counting can happen when suppose you actually bought sugar. You actually bought sugar and you ate it. You actually bought sugar and you actually ate it. Now, here the price of sugar must be counted in national income. But suppose with the sugar you actually made a delicious Kesari Bhat. This is basically a sweet. So when you actually make a delicious Kesari Bhat and you sell it in hotel, then what will happen? You have to take only the price of Kesari Bhat and you should not take the price of sugar. But sometimes you may also take the price of sugar and you may also take the price of Kesari Bhat, and this will result in double counting, which will artificially increase the price of national income. Suppose the price of sugar was 2 rupees, and the price of Kesari Bhat. So thing is, when we are actually speaking about the price of Kesari Bhat, here is the Kesari Bhat. So the price of Kesari Bhat is 25 rupees. In this 25 rupees, the 2 rupees is also included. In this 25 rupees, what do you actually mean? The 2 rupees is also included. So your national income of in which Kesari Bhat is calculated, there the sugar's price is also included. So that is the thing. But however, if you are not preparing Kesari Bhat, if you are not actually preparing Kesari Bhat, then the 2 rupees must be included. Now this actually becomes a problem, right? So thing is, if you actually include the price of Kesari Bhat as well as sugar, then your national income will become 27 rupees. But actually your national income is 25 rupees. So here there will be a confusion. We should include the price of sugar or we should not include the price of sugar. So this creates a problem in a double counting. That is the problem which is actually we actually see in national income. Right. Calculating national income. So this is a problem. Next is lack of reliable data. Lack of reliable data basically means like people will be there, right? They will be earning 10 crore rupees, 20 crore rupees. But for the country government, when the income tax actually comes, they will tell like, no. Thing is, we are earning only 5 crores and we will pay our tax to 5 crores. Although these people are actually earning 10 crores. Although these people are actually earning 10 crores, they are saying 5 crores. So these people will not actually tell what their actual income is. And because of that, we cannot actually calculate what the real national income is, because the people who are earning money, they will always not tell the amount of money they are earning. Always they will undermine, underreport some people, not all people, but most of the people. Most of the people means again, not all the people, but like 30, 40% people will do like this. Right. Like, I don't know the exact statistics, but anyway, some people will do. And because of which the national income will be artificially lowered. Because I am saying, let's say suppose there are three people in the country. One is earning 10, other is earning 10, the other is earning 10. Okay, there are three people in the country and each person is earning 10 rupees, 10 rupees, and 10 rupees. But when the income tax department, where here you have income tax department, and when income tax department says, the person A will tell, I am earning 8 rupees. Person B will tell, I am earning 9 rupees. Person C will tell, I am earning 10 rupees. So here, what will the national income be? National income is 27, but the actual national income is 30 rupees, which is actually lowered because some people are actually not reporting their real income properly. Right, that is lack of reliable data. And apart from that, the next thing is the problem of specialization. See, obviously, when you are actually speaking about the teachers in India, most of the teachers, those teachers are actually not paid good salary. And some intelligent teachers will be there, like this person. This person is obviously teaching in school, and again, he's also running a home tuition. Because this person is an intelligent person, and that is why he is like a very, very intelligent person he is. So this person is earning money in a school, earning money in home tuition. Whatever earning money in school, suppose this person is there. Right, suppose this person is earning 100 rupees in school and he's earning 30 rupees in home tuition. This 30 rupees this person will not tell to the government, because if he tells to the government, he has to pay tax for the government. So although his real income, this person's real income, this person's actual income is 130 rupees, but for the government he's only reporting 100 rupees. The tuition fees of 30 rupees he's actually not reporting for the government. And this person is earning, say, some 50 rupees from 50 rupees from school, and he's not taking any home tuitions, no home tuitions. He's not taking any home tuitions, so his actual income, real income, all income is only 50 rupees. Right. So that is something like which we basically have to understand. Sometimes the teachers also do this, home tuitions, and whatever the money they get in home tuition, they will not. So this is what is, it's not only teachers, it's any person who's engaged in two or three activities, and he is submitting to the government only income from one activity and skipping the other activities. Skipping the other activities, and because of this, obviously, the national income will be artificially lowered. Because of this, the national income will be artificially lowered, and even this also creates a problem in calculating the national income. Right. See, in the previous class, I asked a question. In the previous class, I asked a question, that is, why America shifted from GNP to GDP? American economy was there. American economy actually shifted from GNP to GDP. I asked, why did America do it? See, when you are actually speaking about gross national product, when you are actually speaking about gross national product, what is the meaning of gross national product? Gross national product is the final value of all goods and services which are produced by your country's nationals. Nationals in a period or in a given period of time, that is in normally 1 year. And when you're actually speaking about GDP, GDP is nothing but it actually is GDP nothing but it is the final value of all goods and services which are produced in the domestic territory of your country, which is actually produced in the domestic territory of your country in a given period of time, normally 1 year. So America, which was following GNP, shifted to GDP. Why? Because GNP means the amount of money made by your nationals. The nationals may not be in your country, the nationals may be in other countries. And if GNP is increasing, it just means your people are making more money. It does not mean that your people are in your country and making more money. The people may be going outside and making more money. So it does not actually reflect the true strength of your economy. It does not actually reflect the true strength of your economy and the countries which rely more of its people going abroad and working. Those countries will be called, will actually be called as post box economies. Those countries are actually called as post box economies. And obviously this is not something like which we have to like take into consideration. This is something which is actually wrong. All right, so post office economy, so obviously it undermines the strength of your country, and obviously it undermines the strength of your economy, and that is the thing which we basically have to like totally understand. All right, so this is something like which we basically have to understand, and this is something which we have to understand. However, gross domestic product, if gross domestic product is increasing, so what does it actually mean? If gross domestic product is actually increasing, it actually means that your country is able to create employment opportunities. Your country is actually able to create employment opportunities, and your country is actually able to create employment opportunities. And because of that, many people are coming to your country, and many people are actually working in your country, which is actually a good thing to do. Right. So thing is, if other people are actually coming to your country and actually they are working, so obviously it is a good thing. Which we have to like, GDP is increasing, it means that your country's domestic economy is increasing, and that is something which we have to like. So that is something, and that is the reason why America did not want to, America wanted to measure the true strength of its country, And that is something which we have to like totally take into consideration. That is what American economy totally took into consideration, and they shifted from GNP to GDP, because GDP obviously reflects the true strength of your economy. How much this thing, true strength of your economy, how much your country can actually create employment opportunity, which is not reflected by GNP. So that is the thing. And yes, people, you people just enjoy the rest of your day, and whatever, we shall meet again next.